How do I look? I look nice.
Stephens, and welcome to a house of prayer. As for me and my house, we shall serve the Lord. Today we're at Newport Jewelers and we are entertaining our guests, Daniel.
Arik.
Daniel. Hi. Arik.
My name is Daniel Arik and I'm a co-owner of Newport Jewelers. We're a family-owned business with me, my brother Gabe, and my dad. My father created the company about 35 years ago with a manufacturer in downtown LA. We also have a retail store in Fullerton. This is one of our newest locations in Newport Beach.
Uh-huh.
And we're very excited to be here with you guys.
Thank you so much. Now, we're here celebrating life today with the event that's coming up at the end of January,
yes.
Which is the
Ms America Pageant.
Wow, that's exciting. And
we're very, very excited for the Ms America Pageant, especially with customizing the crown.
Mm-hmm.
Which we are doing. We talked to a lot of people. We got a lot of input from a lot of people, especially Susan,
okay.
Which gave us a lot of good advice on what to do with the piece and how she would like it and what she thinks would be good, because she said it needs to be something appropriate for a woman older than the age of 26. So we put our team together with about 5 designers, and me and my brother also sat down with them, and we created something with genuine diamonds, colored diamonds, colored stones, and Swarovski crystals. And it should be something that's, I mean, it'll explain itself when you see it. I mean, it's an unbelievable piece.
It sounds lovely. So, you know, in reference to celebrating life, what does the crown represent? Now, the Miss America pageant crown is very beautiful, it's wonderful, but does it have a meaning? Does it represent something?
Yes, the crown actually does represent something. The way we designed it and the color stones that we used and the diamonds that we used and the design that we used represents the womanhood and empowerment that women have brought us in general in life, not just from the pageant, women in general. And what it is the crown that's given to the woman, she's supposed to use it and embrace it to go forward with other women, to help others and represent themselves.
So she's a symbol of empowerment. The crown embodies
exactly
empowerment.
It symbolizes empowerment.
And so with that power, we can encourage other women to go out and to do good things.
Exactly.
And to be a positive example in the world.
Exactly. Okay. Exactly. I agree. You put in better words than I did.
Thank you. Well, I see that you have a few pieces here,
yes,
on your counter.
We do, actually. These are some pieces that just represent stuff that we do. I mean, this is a cross with all baguette diamonds and rounds in the center with invisible setting. Take
mm-hmm.
a look at it.
It's lovely.
Sometimes it's a beautiful piece because a piece like this, each stone is chosen by hand to match exactly with it, because something like this, if it's not done perfectly, it's not going to be even. And it's not just one stone. I mean, we use 3 different shapes. We use baguettes, prentice cut, and round stones to give it the uniqueness. And I mean, if somebody that's wearing it feels great because they are representing their religion,
mm-hmm.
and they're wearing something really pretty at the same time.
Well, I love it because it represents Jesus Christ.
Exactly.
And of course, this is what my show is about. As for me and my house, we shall serve the Lord. And it is beautifully designed. I've never seen a cross like this before. I love that it has a center, a heart that's square, and each little level of diamonds is just absolutely beautiful.
Yeah, it's an amazing piece. I mean, we have a group of designers that sit there and just design pieces all day. Just I mean, these guys are amazing.
Is this one of a kind?
This is one of a kind piece, yes.
Oh, it's absolutely beautiful.
Thank you. And actually, my father designed this one.
He did?
Yeah, he designed it for my mother. Oh. And decided to make another one. It's an amazing piece.
I would say that this piece exemplifies celebrating life, and it does have love.
Yeah.
It represents love.
Exactly, exactly.
Very beautiful.
Thank you. Thank you.
And you have another piece here.
This is one of our, this piece is a masterpiece. This took about 6 months to make, because each stone was hand-picked, hand-cut, and hand-chosen to fit this. These are all cushion-cut diamonds.
And what does cushion-cut mean?
Cushion-cut diamond is almost the combination of a round and a apprentice cut, because it almost has the shape of a apprentice cut, but the brilliance of a round, which is cut-cornered, as in the rounded edges. It's an amazing piece. I mean, something like this, you do not see every day. Mm. Very, very unique. I mean, it retails for about $500,000.
Oh, my gosh.
Yeah.
Well, just think, you know, if something like this represents, treasures on this earth,
yeah.
Just imagine when we do good things for others, the treasures that
right.
we build in heaven.
You're absolutely right. Absolutely right.
Wow.
It's a gorgeous piece.
It's called a Prince's Cut.
Cushion Cut.
A cushion cut.
Cushion cut necklace.
Okay.
Cushion cut necklace that goes all the way around. It starts from a 2-carat diamond and goes down to 1.75 and just smallly graduates or gets smaller and smaller. But this is a piece that there was a lot of time and a lot of
taken.
Love. Exactly.
It's a
exactly.
Labor,
labor of love.
Thank you so much. Cool. And we have another piece here.
Now this one is more of a funner, more unique piece. It's a flower. Something like this you will not see every day. I mean, take a look at it. It's a white gold, but it's black rhodium plated. And each line inside this flower, I don't know if they can see it, but it's all hand engraved by the guy. Our designer, our workmanship is just, it's absolutely amazing. The guy will sit there with a microscope and hand touch every single one of these lines and hand set every one of these stones.
It's beautiful.
Mm-hmm.
It's beautiful. And it is a fun piece.
It is. It's more of a funkier piece, it is.
Thank you so much.
No problem.
Well, I know that going back to the Miss America pageant, that the winner of the pageant will absolutely look lovely. And so this is, is this a donation? Is this something that you are just...
It is a donation.
Wow.
It is a donation. I mean, we felt responsible and we came to them. I mean, the way we did it was just mutual. Business friends, stuff like that. But when the idea came across, I loved it.
Mm-hmm.
And I jumped on it right away because I wanted to be a part of it. I thought it symbolized something great. It was something very unique. And, I give women credit for everything they do in this world. I mean, especially my mother. You know, my mother's always taken care of me since I was a little kid, always done everything for me. So I think it's the least I could do.
I think so. So with that said, I like to invite everyone to enjoy the Ms. America pageant, enjoy the these items that have been provided for the pageant as a celebration of life.
Yeah. Also, what we did too is I forgot to tell you, for the first 20 contestants, they also get a customized pendant too.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Tell me about that.
So, we were sitting there one day designing the crown, and I was like, there's more than one winner, because every single woman came into this contestant and they worked hard and they put their time and effort into it, so everybody deserves something when they walk out. So we're customizing a pendant. I can't tell you what it is because it is a surprise. I won't even tell Susan what it is, so she's kind of calling me every day trying to get it out of me, but I won't tell her. But I think it's something nice that they deserve.
Thank you, and congratulations for the women that are going to be delightfully surprised.
Yeah.
Well, good evening, and welcome to the 2011 Ms. America pageant. We are here live at the DoubleTree Guest Suites in Anaheim, California. And tonight, you are going to meet 26 remarkable women from all over the country and watch them compete for the coveted title of Ms. America. Now let's meet these wonderful contestants as they take the stage to open the show.
Miss America, Bridget Cleary.
From
again to the pageant and our festival of beauty, intelligence, and ambition. Before the night is done, we'll be crowning a new Ms. America. The Ms. America pageant was founded in 1997 with the mission to empower and enrich women across the nation and across the world. The pageant has been developed to promote, honor, and advance the status of women, help advance their careers, encourage personal growth and individual development, and use the crown for a purpose, to support and encourage their involvement in social and humanitarian causes across America and around the world.